professional FIFA player for Manchester City, former ePremier League winner, up against a casual FIFA player. Can he find that winner, or can I get it myself?
Oh! So fake, that. Hi, I'm Kalvin Phillips from Manchester City Football Club.
Hi, I'm Shellzz, FIFA player from Manchester City.
You're watching ePL Uncut
on the Premier League YouTube.
Kicking things off, first of all, I want to know a little bit more about both of you. Kalvin, when did you know you were going to make it as a footballer?
Probably when I first signed for Leeds, to be honest. Yeah. It was when I was 14, so it was quite late and got time to enjoy football with my friends first, and then went into the academy when I was 14, so I just knew that was something that I really wanted to do.
Okay. And Shellzz, a little bit different for you, obviously coming from the gaming aspect of FIFA as well. How's that for you? When did you know? You know what? I'm actually pretty good at this.
Yeah, I didn't really believe in myself. I think when I first got my contract and my first team, I could tell my parents I'm actually getting a full-time salary and being able to live with it. I think that was the first time I kind of believed in myself, but it took me a while. I think when I broke onto the scene, I still didn't think I was good enough. But yeah, I'll say after my first year, so when I was 18.
And Kalvin, obviously the real life game, a little bit different to FIFA. You do play a little bit of FIFA yourself. In the real life game, what does it actually mean being on that pitch? Because for Shellzz, the pressure may be a little bit different.
To be honest, I don't really feel much pressure, to be honest. More of just, I enjoy doing it and I've always enjoyed playing football. So I just go out there and try and enjoy myself as much as possible. And I'm pretty sure for Shellzz, it's the same thing when he's playing. He enjoys playing and that's why he does it. So.
Do you feel any sort of same pressure maybe when you've got a competitive FIFA game at all, or any competitive games?
Probably more competitive playing FIFA than what I am in real life, to be honest. So.
I'm a little bit worried because we're going to have a game a little bit when we play against Kalvin and Shellzz. And yeah, that worries me just a little bit. But for you, Shellzz, on the virtual pitch, what's the pressure like there?
I don't feel any pressure from City, but like you want to perform for them when you're playing for such a big club, you want to represent. And for me, I want to win trophies. So always aim to win high and beat the best. So I always put pressure on myself.
Kalvin, you mentioned there about pressure. Playing for Manchester City, what's that been like coming to you into this team and having such amazing facilities, unbelievable players around you?
It's been very difficult, to be honest. Obviously, you know, I knew straight away when I was first coming to the team, it wasn't something that I was going to be playing week in, week out. I was going to have to build my way in. And even now, I'm still at that stage of building myself into the team. So it's been difficult, but I've enjoyed it a lot. And I've learned a lot as well from, you know, various different players and the manager. So. You know, it's been one of the best decisions I've made.
And Shellzz, ePremier League final in 2021.
Ollie Leto has to step up, has to score, and he cannot, and Manchester City and Shellzz.
We've got the ePremier League finals coming up. How confident are you?
Obviously, winning it a few years ago, I'm ready to do it again. I want to be the first one to do it twice this year. I'll be with my teammate Ryan and we'll be competing together. But our aim is to win the trophy, of course.
Right then, now it is time to decide your ultimate Manchester City ePremier League team. Starting things off, we're going to go with a goalkeeper position. I don't think this one's going to be too difficult for you both, but you have the option between Edison and Stefan Ortega.
Nah, Edison's for my number one choice for sure.
On to the fullback position. Kyle Walker is one of my nemesis on FIFA. Shellzz, I'm sure you've come up against him a lot.
Yeah, for sure. He's one of the first names in the team sheet for me.
So next up, at centre-back, you've got the choice of Laporte or Ruben Diaz.
Who's quickest?
So Laporte is 61, Ruben is 63, so...
Ruben then. And he's high rated, to be fair, so it'd make your team look a lot better.
So, Akanji versus John Stones, final decider, who are you having?
I think going for Akanji.
Yeah, I'm happy with that.
Yeah.
Going for Akanji. Okay, moving over into the left back position. You have the option of team of the week item, Cancelo, or you could have Ake at left back.
My left back goes forward, so Cancelo is one of the best on the ball.
I agree with that.
That's it then. So, centre mid position, Kevin De Bruyne or the hero Yaya Toure?
Oh no, you can't be doing this.
I'm going to have to go with the hero, Yaya Toure, I think.
I agree.
Just simply because of the power and the pace that he's got on the game.
Rule breaker, Kalvin Phillips, yourself. Are you going to find a way into the team? It's going to be a choice of you or Rodri.
I'd go with me, to be honest.
I don't know, this Rodri card actually looks all right. It's just, nah, we've got to go with the main man, of course.
Do you better play with this card, and it's actually really good.
And our last option in the midfield department, Bernardo Silva or Gundogan?
I'll say Bernardo Silva.
Yeah.
On the right wing, you've got a choice of Riyad Mahrez or Cole Palmer, who I've heard and seen, he's a very good FIFA player.
Yeah, I played against him and he gave me a hell of a game. I think I've only won 1-0. and I was sweating.
Really?
Yeah.
Is
wait, have you played him?
No, I've never played.
I played against him and Phil, and they are incredible.
Really?
Like, I beat Phil 2-1, luckily. Cole Palmer 1-0, so. I want to go with Cole, because like, I played him, but Mahrez got a 5-star skill, so I'll let you be the decider.
I think we've got to go with Mahrez, haven't we?
Left wing though, Foden or Jack Grealish?
It's a very tough choice. I think they're both good in different ways, but I think on the game, I'd go with Phil Foden.
And then moving on to the striker position, the final position, is there a debate? Erling Haaland and Alvarez?
You can't look past Haaland because he is the freak, so.
There we have it then, that is the starting 11. Shellzz, over to you for the bench. De Bruyne, obviously a player that could come on and change that game. The fact that he's not in the starting 11 alone is...
That feels wrong, like I said, but he's definitely the first guy on the bench. I'm happy Cole's there, maybe get some few minutes. But I might put Gundogan in for Rodri. As I say, I'm a pace merchant, so that's all I look for. But I'm happy with this bench.
Kalvin Phillips up against myself. We're going to do that first. And every time Kalvin concedes, we're going to swap things over. And Shellzz will jump in to try and claw that one back. But the rules are, every time you concede, there will be a forfeit.
Yeah.
And if it gets a 3-0, that's it. You're done. Kalvin, good luck.
Cheers,
go
mate.
Easy on me.
I feel like I'm not even going to touch the controller. I think Kalvin's secretly a gamer.
Haaland trying to make
that. To be fair, seeing how he's moving the ball already, I know this guy plays a lot, so.
Hey, that's me in the yellow. Kalvin in the blue.
Oh, no.
Ball coming in, cross.
Oh, lad.
People at home that are maybe thinking, you know what? I want to give FIFA a go. I want to try and see how good I can get. What's kind of one or two tips that you'd ask them to get on board with?
Kind of just try and compete as much as you can, I think.
Oh! Oh.
Competing is the best way to improve, and it kind
no,
of...
No, none of this short corner stuff. Nah.
Foden on the edge. Chance.
No, come finish his dinner.
I would have whipped that corner in if that was me, I'm not going to lie.
In the goal?
Yeah, if you move the keeper, 100%.
Shot from range. How often do you shoot from outside the 18-yard box, Shellzz?
Travellers, so I do it quite often.
Oh, the outside of the boot?
Yeah, that was very overpowered this year. So anytime I get a right foot on the right, cutting in. At the pro level, a lot of you kind of watch it, but you try and sneak it whenever you can. So maybe twice a game, I'll try to put one off.
Especially if you green time them as well.
Yeah.
And for people that are watching, that are thinking, green time finishing, what's that? How crucial is that to a competitive FIFA players game?
If you can master time finishing, I'm pretty sure you'd win a lot more matches than you currently do now. Even that's something I'm struggling with, because to be consistent with it is quite tough.
Yeah.
Time finishing is where you time the shot, and if you time it green, it kind of, you get a good connection with it and more chance of it going in.
Haaland. Oh, what a beauty! I'll be honest,
so
I didn't think
fake.
That was going in.
It's so fake, that.
I'm just seeing long shots everywhere, man. Where's the passes? It's not really City.
Now, Shellzz will come over. And at this pause as well, you do have some forfeits to take. And it is going to be three substitutions. Now, you're not going to get to choose those substitutions either. I get to bring them on. So, you know, I mentioned about the bench and who you wanted.
Yeah.
You said about Kevin De Bruyne maybe coming on. Kevin De Bruyne won't be coming on, unfortunately. Chance, though. Move that.
Nah.
No, we're back in the game.
I lasted how long? About 2 minutes after I went 1-0 up. And Shell's showing the class that he has. So, I've got to match it. We've both got to make three substitutions. So I get to make three subs for you and you get to make three subs for me. Quick one, who am I taking off? Who am I bringing on? I mean, you could put Rodri up front if you wanted to.
Yeah.
It's not a bad shout.
I don't know why I've just said that. That's probably a bad idea. Haaland is coming off. Rodri, next up.
Akanji for Bernardo Silva.
Okay.
Gundogan for Edison.
I've got Gundogan in goal. Moving over to you. So I'm going to go with Palmer in goal, please, for Edison.
Oh, no.
Alvarez at centre-back for Diaz. And then John Stones up front for Haaland. And let's go. Let's kick things straight back off. 1-1. Gundogan's in goal for me. So that just means shoot from range and you probably score. Kyle Walker with that pace, though. Absolutely bursting away there. Shellzz, when it comes to the Premier League finals,
yeah.
You've got five substitutions as well this year. How much do you think they play a part in the game?
Fresh legs late on in the game, I think, makes a huge impact, you know. Just imagine on something on Kyle Walker late on in the game, just no one's getting past him. But yeah, no, it's very important.
Kalvin as well, when it comes to substitutions, we just spoke about them in the virtual game.
Mm-hmm.
What's it like coming on in the 70th minute of a game that maybe you're winning?
Horrible.
You need to grab a goal back. Horrible? Not a fan of it?
No.
No?
Would you prefer when you're losing or winning?
Phillips. Ooh, oh, go on the rebound, yeah.
Well, you're distracting him. This will...
Yeah,
I mean,
I can't talk and play at the same time.
No? Not a fan of that?
No. No, I'd say I'd much rather come on when we're losing, to be honest. Because you've got nought to lose then, have you?
Yeah.
You can literally go on and just...
try and make that difference.
Yeah, but if you don't and it goes 4-0 down then...
That's got to hurt though, seeing me score with your item in-game.
Yeah, he was talking to me, so I wasn't even concentrating. Yeah.
Excuses, that's what I hear, excuses.
And give it 2 minutes.
That is 2-1 to me. Shellzz, you're taking over the controller. There's going to be another forfeit. And the forfeit is that you have to go ultra-attacking, which obviously will be constant pressure and turn on overload ball side.
Oh no, so you're trying to kill my stamina.
And for everyone at home, overload ball side, what is it, Shellzz? How does it work on FIFA?
You can't play it for a whole game, but your team basically has every man behind the ball. There's no gaps in the box, so it's pretty much impossible to break down. But with constant pressure, I don't know if that would work.
And you tend to use that in a game where you're trying to see out maybe the last 10 minutes. We've got a chance here. Cancelo, though. The footwork. Oh, he's missed it.
Yeah, I mean, I only use it maybe 80th minute if I'm really struggling to defend against an opponent when he's trying to grab a late minute goal.
I didn't even know you could do that, you know.
Yeah, no, it was actually a secret thing. Only a few pros knew at the start of like FIFA 20, and then everyone was doing it by then.
So, Kalvin, you got to clutch up now.
And unless you survive to half time.
You've got to survive till kickoff.
Survive till half time.
So play for last attack if you can.
So what is last attack? What does that mean?
So when it's like 44th, 87th minute, pros kind of just want to make sure they have the last attack of the game, because if you lose the ball and concede, you know, you're going to be, there's no chance of really coming back into it.
Did my job, survive till half time.
Kalvin survives till half time, 2-2. Next goal winner, Shellzz has that kickoff. Professional FIFA player for Manchester City, former ePremier League winner, up against casual FIFA player. Can he find that winner, or can I get it myself?
Why do I feel like you're going to score now?
I've got Rodri up front and Gundogan in goal. So, chance.
Oh, big good defending. Tackle.
Big defending now. The opportunity. Shellzz likes to move the ball quick. Likes your skill moves as well. Haaland not really too capable with that.
Oh, no.
The breakaway. Foden. Okay, the chance. Go on. Oh! I found it at the near post.
You know what it is as well?
What is it?
We got a Cole Palmer in goal.
Nah, subs didn't even work.
For you or for me?
No, we have Haaland still on.
Oh, I mean, that's even better for me because my substitutions came through.
Yeah, but I was going to say it, innit? But then...
That looks worse for you now, though, Kalvin. You and Shellzz have just been beaten.
No, but our goalkeeper's still on.
Our subs didn't work, so it's a void game.
I don't think that's how it works, really.
Nah, but Cole would have made that save, though.
You think?
Yeah.
Edison, Cole Palmer in goal at that near post? Let me know in the comments who you think would save that, because I think that's a little bit of excuses coming through.